Welcome back, everybody. This is Gerard here with Linden Sports Center. It is the week after Thanksgiving. Today we are out here with a Hewescraft 270 Pacific Explorer. We're going to take it out here on the water and we will show you the in and outs of this boat. As you can see, we made it out here on the water. The first ride on this boat was very comfortable. Inside of the cabin, it was warm and comfortable. As you can maybe tell outside, it's pretty cold and windy. The twin 200 Mercuries ran great. The whole shot in this boat was phenomenal and top speed was just over 40 miles an hour. Now let's get into the boat and we'll show you some of the features of this Hewescraft. Going around here, this boat is rigged with two Canon downriggers, Mag 10 downriggers. Down here we have the switches for our wash down and our fish box pump out and the live well. And going over here we have our big insulated live well where the lid also doubles as a cutting board. Then if we keep going right here, we have our transom door which can get us out on the transom. It gives us easy access for landing fish. Also, our ladder is right here to get in and out of the boat for the days you want to go swimming. And then when we continue on right here, we have our switch panel with all our breakers and battery switches. Then in the floor, we have a big fish box. We have one on the starboard and there's also one on the port side. When we keep going around right here, we have our rear helm. We have controls for both of the Mercury motors. Then we have our steering. And up here we have a 9-inch Simrad graph that is also tied into the radar and autopilot. On top of the hardtop we have a set of rocket launchers, one on each side to hold up 8 rods. The bulkhead door does lock in the open position, so it's easy to keep it open when you're out on the water. Then we have a storage compartment, and then as you can see down here we have our hookup for our shore power, which is an option the customer went for on this boat. Also, right here above the bulkhead, we have our floodlight to light up the entire bag deck, which is handy for the early mornings going out and late nights coming back. So with the shore power we have on this boat, when the boat is plugged into shore, we have a 110 outlet over here. We have one under the dinette. There is another one in the cuddy. And then also there's one in the back, which charges the batteries in the boat automatically when you're plugged in. Right when you come inside the bulkhead door, right behind the captain's chair on the starboard side, we have a nice large kitchenette. Up here we have some kitchen storage. Then here we have a 2-burner diesel stovetop that can also double as a heater when the lid's closed. We have a sink with fresh water on board. Down here we have a 12-volt refrigerator. And then we have lots of storage compartments for all your storage needs. Here on the port side we have a spacious head. It does come with privacy curtains, light in the ceiling. It also has a drain in the floor so you can use it to wash up and the water will be pumped overboard as gray water. Then if we keep going on the port side we have our dinette. It does have storage under all the seats and this will also turn into a bed. The table can be lowered and then this backrest goes in here to turn it into a bed for someone to sleep. This seat in the dinette can flip both directions, so you can have it in this configuration, the face forward, and if you want to rotate, turn the seats around, you can do so to sit at the table. We have our very comfortable captain's chair. Underneath of it is storage as well, in a big compartment. And then also in the floor of this boat, we have lots of storage everywhere. Right now we're in our captain's chair. This has a lot of suspension for a smooth ride on the rougher days. Going around here, we have our cup holders, our controls for the motor, trim tab controls. Then we have our switch panel for everything in the boat, our windlass switch. Right here, we mounted our VHF radio and a Mercury Vessel View 403. And then up here, we have a 12-inch graph, which is linked to the 9-inch graph in the back. And then we have a radar and autopilot on this boat as well. Here in the nicely finished ceiling, we have grab handles for rougher water. We have four lights spread around the cabin. Then going forward, we have defrost fans for the front windshield. And then we also installed these fans to blow, to move air onto the people on board. And then also here we have our windows, which will slide open with screens on them for keeping the bugs out in the summertime. And right here going forward, we have our cuddy. There is lots of storage in here again, underneath all here. Right here is more storage. We have the storage trays on the side. This will sleep two people fairly comfortable. We do have a hatch out the top. Right here, which will also give you access to the windlass if you have to get there, or the bow of the boat. Also, because we have the diesel stove slash heater on board, we have carbon monoxide alarms inside the cuddy and also one inside the cabin. Then through our front windshield, you can see we have the big tall bow rails to keep you safe when you are up there. And also we have a windlass anchor installed on this boat. Back out of the water again. We hope you guys enjoyed watching this walkthrough video of this Hewescraft 270 Pacific Explorer. And we hope you guys will check back with us in the future for more videos to come.